We must tell you, you must cancel the normal Thanksgiving plans.
This is a great day for our country. We get to take our democracy back.
Yeah!
Yeah! And I just want to say, for all those people who voted,
amen,
you made this happen.
Oh, wow. Yeah!
Have fun, celebrate, be safe. I'm glad all the people are wearing masks.
Yeah!
Everybody has to take care. Everybody has to take precaution. I will tell you, in that big crowd a week ago, everybody was wearing masks. Look at, you can see the shot here. Mask compliance in our city is actually up very, very high. But yes, there are times when we actually do need to have a relief and come together. And I felt like that was one of those times. That crowd was gathered whether I was there or not.
Chicago's mayor has declared a stay-at-home advisory, but it doesn't have a lot of teeth to it in terms of enforcement. Now, the governor of Illinois says he may declare a stay-at-home order. And then he said this: to all of you who have questioned the data and fueled these conspiracy theories, what's it going to take to make this real for you?
The new restrictions start Monday morning. Mayor Lightfoot said this is not a complete shutdown, but rather a limit on the size of social gatherings. Residents are being asked to only leave home for work, school, groceries, and medical care, and only if you are wearing a mask. Chicago's rate of people testing positive has now hit 14%.
The new CDC guidelines for small gatherings include requiring everyone to wear a mask, even outdoors, avoiding direct contact, including handshakes and hugs, keeping music levels down to avoid people singing or trying to shout over the noise, avoiding potluck-style gatherings, and having one person serve all the food so multiple people are not handling the serving utensils.
Just because you are within your own home doesn't mean you're necessarily safe. If you have people coming in that are not part of your close nuclear circle that you see regularly, the question you really ask is, the person that I'm about to meet, who has that person been meeting over the last few days? In what circumstances might that person not have been wearing a mask? Where could transmission have happened? And could this now be introduced into my social circle or into my home?
Loud settings. The louder you speak, if you're singing, if you're playing darts, standing next to someone in a crowded bar and you're yelling back and forth, it seems like these things shouldn't be as risky or elevated. What we've seen is that they do that.
Reduce the number of people at your gathering. If you can open the windows, let more ventilation in. We've got very practical things. Even if you have a ceiling fan, set it so it pulls the air up instead of down. Use single-use servings for individuals. Wear your face coverings, because I want to make sure, even if we make sacrifices this Thanksgiving and Christmas, those sacrifices are for a reason.
Are you willing to quarantine for 14 days starting today before you see loved ones? Or are you willing just to celebrate with your household members? Now is a huge moment that we can take steps to slow the spread in the community, or else we're just going to get even worse. And this is the big concern now, right? Pandemic fatigue. We're seeing these numbers, these statistics. Do they hit home enough for people to actually do what it takes?
Dr. Fauci, do you believe that we're headed for a national lockdown?
You know, I don't know. We would like to stay away from that, Robin, because there is no appetite for locking down on the American public. But I believe that we can do it without a lockdown. I really do.